Hi, and welcome to Leslie's Lab. In this episode, we're going to take a look at this. This is a Tektronix 2232 oscilloscope that I recently picked up at auction for a really great price. Let's stick it on the bench and take a look. This is a Tektronix 2232 100 MHz digital oscilloscope that I picked up from an auction recently. I actually got this for £100. It was sold as seen. No other information, it was just basically what's on the photograph. This was a really good auction score, it wasn't eBay, there are other places to get oscilloscopes in the UK. I've got my Hewlett-Packard 20 meg analog oscilloscope on the bench, and normally for day-to-day use I use a Rigold DS1054Z, which has had the firmware update to 100 meg, but I wanted a decent 100 megahertz analog oscilloscope. So what came with it, the front cover came with it, it's way over there. I've got nice ×1 ×10 probe. In the bag there was a bunch of other accessories as well, which kind of makes this an even better bargain. I've got the little probe tweaker. There's more probes as well. I've got a nice current probe. Never sort of had the need for one of these, but now I have it, I'm sure I'll use it. There's a ×1 probe in here. Again, this is a Tektronix probe. It's got the little slip ring on there so that it can do probe detect. There's another ×1 probe. I don't know what these guys were doing with all the ×1 probes. There's the passive probe annual. And then there's the actual manual itself. This was actually in the cellophane wrapping when I got the thing. And it's, you know, the entire user manual for the scope. So obviously I'm gonna have to spend some time reading this to use all of the features. But pretty good, everything's in a neat bag that's mounted on the top of the scope. I'll just fire all this stuff back in there. This actually unclips it's mounted on a metal plate, and you could just bend it up and yank the thing off. So we'll just get rid of that. And the scope itself is fully working. What a bargain. So we'll just power this thing on. Wanted one of these because they've got really nice bright traces, and well, it's a 100 megahertz analog oscilloscope, and who wouldn't want one? So we've got a nice readout at the bottom of the screen there. Nice bright trace. And we'll just hook onto the calibration point there. So there's our calibration square wave. You'll notice, actually, I noticed this at first and I actually thought it was perhaps there was something wrong with the scope, but there's a flicker on the trace, and it's quite pronounced. If you go down to fairly long time base, you can see chunks sort of missing out the waveform, and it actually turns out that while it's busy writing the characters to the bottom of the screen there, the beam obviously has to move. It's a single beam oscilloscope, beam has to move and write your characters. You can actually get the objectionable flicker turned off just by turning off the digital display at the bottom there. Turn that back on. Awesome. So yeah, pretty good. So that's channel one working. Channel two works as well. I tested it earlier today. There's channel two. Awesome. It says it's a digital storage oscilloscope. You can actually choose between digital and analog. I'll show you guys that in a minute. I noticed something sort of else curious as well. I've not had a Tektronix for years about the flicker, and all that kind of carry on. But there's an interesting thing. There's a bandwidth limit switch on here. And if you turn off the bandwidth, so when the bandwidth limit's on, it effectively is a 20 megahertz analog oscilloscope. When you turn the bandwidth limit off, it shows you all the noise in the waveform itself, because it's 100 mega oscilloscope. It's interesting that it shows the noise on the actual probe adjust test point. It doesn't actually show any noise on my signal generator. So again, I think it's something deliberate by Tektronix to sort of demonstrate the functionality of their product there. Pretty cool. We've got both channels work as well. We can set them up for. There's channel one, channel two. Awesome. So we've got, you know, it's like I say, a single beam scope, so you've got a choice of alt, where it alternates between traces, and chop, where it actually chops between the traces. You can actually see the chopping on this, which is a bit sort of weird, but I'm not going to complain, you know, £100. So, great. Now, if we switch to storage mode, that's essentially digital, we get a digitized waveform. I'm not convinced, and I'm sure I'll find it's not when I look up in the manual, I'm not convinced it's 100 megahertz in digital storage mode, but really, really nice, really, really detailed waveforms, it has to be said. If you turn the time base away up, obviously at some point, this thing is going to start playing join the dots. There it goes. So yeah, you can see joining the dots. Awesome. So yeah, pretty cool. I mean, honestly, I'm probably going to use it in analog analog mode more often than not, because I wanted a 100 meg analog scope. I mean, if I want a digital scope, I've got my Rigol DS1054Z, and I'm really, really happy with it. But it's pretty cool. What else have we got? We've got all the display, all the menus and stuff. There's the advanced display menu, so you can set up comms and all that kind of jazz. You can do a factory reset on it. There's a plot menu because it supports an external XY plotter. So maybe that'll be a future project. Maybe we'll get that serial data out of there somehow, and you know, maybe plot it on the PC or something, just for the laugh. I mean, you know, again, I can do all this stuff with my Rigol, but what else have we got? Display setup, so you can decide what you want displayed on the display there. Acquisition menu, awesome. Interestingly, the advanced function menus, there's a blank at position number 3. So once you're in advanced function, if you press the blank button twice that has nothing next to it and move the cursor knob, you get a secret menu. It's essentially an Easter egg. It says you can figure out how to exit. Well, you just press the advanced function menu button again. But we've got the tech bug and wizard. If we press tech bug, we get a nice display of the Tektronix logo. I wonder if we can turn up the intensity there. Nice. So this is a nice vector display of the Tektronix logo, which is awesome. In fact, one of the reasons I got this scope is I want to do some vector graphics on it. It's got, you know, you can put it into XY mode, and it's got a Z axis on the back there. If we come out of there, we've got the wizard. So it draws the little tech wizard, and eventually, we'll hang around a minute, this little guy will start moving across the screen, which is kind of nice. So he's disappeared off the bottom there, and he's going from left to right. He'll appear. I can see from the little glow at the bottom of the screen, he's actually down here somewhere. I'm sure he'll find his way up in a minute. I wonder if we can. Oh, we can alter the position. Ah, there we go. We can actually move him around. So he just flies backwards and forwards across the screen. This tech wizard is apparently in the Tektronix manual somewhere. Oh. Really, really nice bright screen. Excellent. I'll just come out of there. So pretty cool. I mean, there's other features on this scope that I haven't sort of taken a look at yet. I mean, we've got readout intensity, we've got intensity for channels A and B. It's got delayed time base, which is something I've never actually used, but I'm sure I'll find a use for it now I have it. All sorts of little bits and pieces there. I can trigger off both channels. We've got external trigger input as well. So I mean, it's, you know, basically everything you'd need in 100 meg analog scope, I think. I'll just come back out of there. So, you know, really, really nice, and let's say really, really bright trace, which would be excellent for displaying video signals and things. That's one of the projects I want to do, is actually display video signals on here from my old 8-bit computers and whatnot. I've got some homemade computers that put out H-Sync and V-Sync and video, and I'm thinking, well, I could feed them into this and it would do a really good job of displaying some graphics. Thanks for watching this episode of Les's Lab. If you want to see more episodes like this, don't forget to hit like and subscribe down below, and I'll see you guys next time.